ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಹಂಪಿಹೊಳಿ, ಹೆಡ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್, ಕೆ ಎಲ್ ಎಸ್ ಗುಪ್ತ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಬೆಳಗಾವಿ. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಫುಲ್ ಟು ವಿ ಟಿ ಯು ಇ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಮೀ ಅಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ ಟು ಬಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಯು, ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್. ಯು ಆರ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕಲ್ ಕೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಹೋಲ್ ಗ್ಲೋಬ್ ಫೇಸಿಂಗ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ಬಿಗ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್. I wish you all the best, and these challenges only motivate engineers to solve problems. So engineers are one who face the challenges. So again, wishing you all the best in all your whole engineering courses, all 8 semesters, and in future. Here Professor Hampiyoli, I am there here to teach you engineering mathematics, first semester engineering mathematics, 18 MAT 11, module 3, that is integral calculus, is my part. So let us have an objective of understanding a little higher level of integration, whatever you have learnt in PUC, that is double integration. So this is my task. I'll be taking 18 MAT 11. Module 3, double and triple integration. So our simple objective will be to understand what you mean by double integration. How it will be the generalization of integration already you know, and let us keep a small objective of, let us not think that integration means only area, differentiation means only slope or velocity. Integration means there is a lot of meaning is there for that. Based on that meaning only, this double and triple integration generalization is done. Generalization is a very wonderful word where we tend to generalize concepts. Whatever we observe, we try to generalize. For example, if 2 days continuously because of weather condition rains are falling, then you try to generalize automatically that third day also there may be rain. Or if you are eating something and if your stomach is getting disturbed first time, second time, third time, you generalize that food doesn't suit me. All these are generalization only. So that generalization, that common sense plus will be used in this technology. And let me come to the definition of integration. So if I understand the definition of whatever integration you know already, so we can generalize it for double and triple integration. So not at all difficult. See, usually what we do is, suppose this is x axis, this is y axis, and I take some sin x, cos x, some f of x curve, which is y equal to f of x. And suppose I want to integrate this between x equal to a to x equal to b. Then before integration, what I do is, I start dividing this interval into small intervals. Suppose I divide into smaller intervals, that is first interval is width is suppose delta x1, second interval suppose width is delta x2. In general I have got smaller interval delta xi, last one suppose delta xn. Like that, this interval AB I divide it into n parts. How many parts? N parts. This interval AB I divided into n parts, first part, second part, and so on, ith part, nth part. Now if this interval is very small, that time what we can take is a point x1 here, a point x1 here, and the height f of x1. after all this point height means it is a real number that you would never forget. Delta x1, this width is a real number. So delta x1 into suppose f of x1, some real number, small real number, anything you write into some number. So we are multiplying two real numbers, output will be real number. Similarly, I'll take f of x2 here and multiply, f of xi here and multiply. So here f of xi I take, and here I take f of xn. Then if I multiply delta x1 into this height, naturally you this into height is naturally this area with small error, but if the width is very very small next to zero, that error also becomes zero. I am multiplying delta x1 into height f of x1 suppose. So this becomes the area, but it is a product of two real numbers is more important. For example, it can be volume into density. Suppose, just for time being, you forget this figure and think that it is volume into density. So that becomes mass. Similarly, whatever concept is there, work in force into distance, that becomes work. So that if you understand that it is a product of two real numbers rather than width and height, then it is more general understanding. Then I continued second width into f of x2. But better way of writing is, in general, value of the function into delta xi. Last nth part f of xn into delta xn. So this becomes at last this whole sum, if I write it as s, becomes a real number. That is important. Instead of sum, now we are not satisfied. We want to make these small intervals also in such a way that each small interval should be very, very small. I want very, very small. Very, very small means how much small? That becomes important. So that before I write something else, I make a notation for this. Sum of all such quantities. Sum of all such quantities. So either you can think width and breadth, height, or you can think some two real numbers multiplying together, giving some quantities like mass or work done. So this n terms, 1 to n terms, I'm adding. But I'm not happy, I told, because I want this delta xi to be so small that this error, whatever is happening, this error is this rectangle is this area. So this becomes error. This error will be 0 provided I make this width almost 0. I cannot make it 0, but next to 0 I can make it. So tending to 0, like this it starts. Tending to 0 means I'll take the limit both sides such that each delta xi, not only one delta xi, all of this delta xi should become 0. Means I have to divide once again. In this also I have to divide again thousands of parts. In this also I have to divide thousands of parts. In this also I have to divide thousands of parts. Thousands of parts, lakhs of parts. It is not lakhs of parts. It is this whole number of divisions. Number of divisions are here 1 and 2. I and n, this number of divisions should tend to infinity. So right hand side also I have to apply the same limit. Limit such that the width is almost 0, not 0, is nothing but beauty of limit. For all n tending to, for n tending to infinity, for all I it should happen, for all I, not only one division you should make infinity, for each one you should make it infinity. Then this limit of right hand side, this limit of right hand side, whatever right hand side is there, on this I am applying limit. So I have to copy paste here, summation I equal to 1 to n. I am telling you the definition of integration already you have learnt. In this way, it is limit of sum, which is delta xi. Now, you are already told about something about limits, but in limits, there are sometimes it happens that it should not be infinity by infinity. It should not be infinity minus infinity. It should not be 0 by 0. And apart from these three, some four more are there ending with 1 raised to infinity. This I liked very much. So there are seven indeterminate forms. This limit should not happen this. If it is not one of these indeterminate seven forms, then we show that if exists, if this limit exists, then whatever the quantity we are getting, if this limit exists, then whatever the quantity we are getting, some real number we will get at last right hand side, because it is product of two real numbers and sum of such infinite real numbers. So that whatever we get, we call it as integration of such a function f of x with respect to x, x equal to a to b, which is we denoted by some integration I. Now I want to generalize it for two dimension. So let us generalize it for two dimension. Why not? So this is one way of generalization always. If you can do for one dimension, you can do for two dimension, you can do it for three dimension. Now I am going to do the definition of double integration. So if at all you are asked this definition, you should be able to reproduce it. So listen to me carefully. If you to understand any time in the life, you can write this definition. Suppose I have a figure here which is so double integration means instead of dx, y naught dx dy. It's very, very layman's language I talked, roughly I talked. So I want two variables. One is x, one is y. So there only along x you are integrating a to b. Now instead of a to b, I will be integrating along c to d also, c to d also. So that if at all roughly I take something x equal to a to b, y equal to c to d, I am going to generate this area. So instead of dividing this interval into n parts, I will divide this whatever the area is there, I will divide into n parts. How? Parallel to x axis, I will draw some lines parallel to parallel to y axis I will draw some lines. So big area is divided into smaller areas. One of the area I will make it as delta AI. One of the area I will denote it by delta AI. And in that I can take one two dimensional point xi, yi. And if at all some surface is there which is a function of x and y, which is suppose height z, some height z is there, at this point I will find the height z, that is f of xi yi, which is also a real number, or some height zi. I will multiply this height into area. So that is something like base into height is volume. So I may get a volume like a pillar like this, roughly. So all such pillars everywhere I start appearing, and summation of all such n parts, for each part delta x1, delta x2, delta x3, delta xn, for each part I will take one point x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3, and take the height, multiply by area, and I am going to get real number into real number is more important at last. So here if you take height into area, it becomes volume. Again if you take mass into volume into density, it becomes again mass only. But this summation, again I want to take limit as number of areas tend to infinity. Each delta AI should be so small that it is point small, so that you will get only x1, y1 of this left hand side is same thing as limit as n tend to infinity. Each of the areas should tend to 0 for all I, for all I. So limit of this sum I equal to 1 to n f of xi yi delta ai. If I expand it, it looks like this. If I expand this in the first area into some point I am taking and height I am taking, multiply area into height, second area, some area will be there, second area, again in that one point x2, y2, again you take height, like that n parts we are taking f of xn, yn, So again, it is a question of real numbers into real number. This becomes a real number. So sum of all n such real numbers is here. So if at all the sum of real numbers, if I am taking n tending to infinity, it is sum of infinite real numbers. When you have sum of infinite real numbers in the limit, it should not become again infinite by infinity, infinity minus infinity, and 0 by 0, 1 raised to infinity, 7 deadly dangerous things, it should not happen. It should be some real number. If exists, I call. If it is not, indeterminate. So you have to listen to this again and again. After the completion of the chapter, you have to come back once again and listen to it. So definitions are always little abstract only. But definitions are so important. Definitions, andre, they are Ugamasthana of any river. Ugamasthana will be very, very small. But when it starts flowing, thousands of miles it flows. It creates history. It creates civilization. It gives lives. Like that, these definitions also create history. It has created double integration history. Limits has created calculus. And all of you know what is happening. If it exists, we call it this integration as double integration, because with respect to x and with respect to y, you are integrating with respect to some area of this function f of xy. So there it was over the area A, or it is some x equal to A to B, y equal to C to D, suppose, and f of xy, each area is something like this, dx into dy, if you imagine in a rectangular coordinate system. So instead of dA, I can write dx dy. This becomes definition of double integration, and this is notation for this. Actually, this is a notation. First times S means it is a sum, S means it is a sum. Very similarly, we define triple integration also. Very, very similarly, so I just give you a mathematical symbol. Triple integration also defined like this only. So definition of triple integration. Instead of two variables dx, dy, here there will be three variables dx, dy, dz. So that summation s will be f of xi, yi, zi, the corresponding volume delta vi, sum of such n terms, if I take the limits, on both sides, limit of S as number of volume subdivisions tend to infinity for all delta Vi tending to 0. So both sides same limit I have to write. Equation means both sides same operations. Taking limit is also one operation only. And if at all this limit exists, after all, again, real number to real number, you should think. Value of the function, here you cannot imagine height and width and all that. It is a product of two real numbers. Instead of three dimension, it can be n dimension integration also. That time, geometry cannot be used. Only algebraically you have to think. If at all exists, we call this integration as triple integration of this function f. Here it is three variables. In one variable, yz was not there. In two variables, z was not there. So here, instead of dvi, I can write dx, dy, dz. For over the x values, over the y values, over the z values, from some x1 to x2, x equal to x1 to x2, y equal to y1 to y2, z equal to z1 to z2. Of course, limits need not be constants. So here, these are the definitions of, if at all asked, you should be able to write. But definitions are altogether different from your integration values. Your objective is to learn what is definition. Now, most important for your examination point of view. So, without making you much wait, I am going to take some how to do some evaluations in double integration. Your knowledge of integration becomes very important. So, in this, you will always get something like evaluate. Let me demonstrate how we do the double integration through some examples. So now onwards it becomes more important. So your basic objective of learning this is, what do you mean by double integration? What do you mean by triple integration? How to evaluate in different formats, like there may be constant limits, there may not be constant limits, and afterwards apply to find area, volume, density, and so on. Afterwards, some more important parts, that is, you are going to learn what is meant by beta and gamma functions, so on and so forth. These are our simple objectives. Now we don't know, at the end of this chapter, after listening to this, you should be able to understand how to evaluate double integration. Now, first example, evaluate double integration, 1 to 3, 1 to 2, x, y square, dx, dy. Now, in the first case, what you should do is, whenever such integration is given, first of all, you write first as it is, okay, as it is, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 2, x, y square, dx, dy. Whichever is first one, that becomes the limit of first one, unless and until it is given separately here. If it is already y equal to 1, 2, 3 is given, then you have to take it for y. So, it is not given means, usually, first one you take as first one, second one you take as remaining. So, now you know the limits, x limits, y limits. So, now, I equal to, before I write I equal to, one important thing, always when there are two independent variables, one remains as a constant. Like, if there are two independent variables, x and y in a rectangle, if I change one here, see whether y is changing, y is not changing, y remains constant. So, x and y are relatively constants. So, that's why I write integrate with respect to x. It is almost similar to partial differentiation techniques, keeping or treating time being y as a constant. That means in your mind, with respect to x, this y square term should be something like 10x. So, only dx will act. Dy is also something constant. So, only x dx will be integrating as x square by 2. So, y remains something like 10. It becomes constant. So, let us integrate now. So, y you don't touch. Remaining x dx becomes your usual integration, x square by 2, whatever the limits are there, 1, 2, 3, x equal to 1, 2, 3. So, now evaluation part, upper limit minus lower limit, we know that. So, let us put the limits now. See, dear children, how we put limits? Y equal to 1, 2, 2, I am writing as it is, y square I am not touching, dy I am not touching, divided by 2 as it is, upper limit, wherever x is there, you put 3. First, you put 3 here, it becomes 3 square, minus lower limit, you put x equal to 1, minus 1 square. Now, this becomes 9 minus 1, 8 upon 2, 4 I can keep out and integrate the remaining part with respect to y. So, this is again ordinary integration. You know that y square becomes y cube by 3. 4 times y cube by 3, so it is equal to y equal to 1, 2, 2. Whatever you did for limits, whatever you did for x limits, very similarly you do for y limits. First you put y equal to 2, it becomes 4 here, 3 here, upper limit is 2 means 2 cube, minus always first you write minus the lower limit, minus 1 here means 1 cube. It is 8 minus 1, which is 4 by 3 into 8 minus 1 is 7. So, total answer at last is 28 by 3. See, dear children, at last it is a real number. A real number can be mass, density, viscosity, velocity, work done, anything with some units. So, all these integration differentiations are going to give you some real number. In the concept, whatever is there, you will get that answer. So, now, slight change in the second example, I will be doing slight change, how to integrate again, see how I integrate. example number 2. I equal to integrate x equal to 1 to 2, y equal to 2 to 3. Already it is given, suppose. X square y plus x y square dx dy. Now, since it is integration is with respect to all the limits are constants, any order you can take first. First you can integrate with respect to x, then take the limits for x. Or first you can integrate with respect to y, then take the limits for y. Any order, first x then y or first y then x, both will be the same. And as long as now I will integrate with respect to, y. So, customer is to tell that keep x constant, keep means time being our x is constant, So, then here it is not like previous case. In previous case there only the factors were there. Now, wherever y is there, you should have an eye on them. Wherever y is there, see here y is there constant. Here y is there constant. Something like x square into 10 x square, something like some 5x plus 5x dx. So x square becomes x cube by 3, don't touch y, x becomes x square by 2. So that integrating with respect to y, I am telling, so it is reverse. Keep x constant, which is not marked, keep x constant, y dy becomes y square by 2, y square dy becomes y cube by 3. So, don't touch x now, don't touch this x, plus don't touch this x. So, this y, wherever y is there, so this y dy, y square by 2, in the limits 2 to 3, y square becomes y cube by 3. In the beginning, we shall go slow like this. So, you should get used to it. So, that today I told two important terms, generalization and getting used to. Very important, think again and again, what is the meaning of this? Getting used to means familiar. To which you are familiar, you will be more skillful in that. Virat Kohli plays cricket, he is familiar to that, he cannot play football. But somebody else playing football, they play football. A fisherman's sons are very, very used to water, they can play with water, we cannot. I am close to familiar to mathematics. So, whichever you are familiar, that will count you. So, if at all you want to achieve something, try to become familiar to that by reading again and again, by practicing again and again, nobody can stop you. Now, upper limit minus lower limit, don't touch x. So, upper limit minus lower limits. So, here x square and this x I am not touching. Y square by 2. Wherever y is there, put upper limit 3 square minus 2 square. Okay. So, this 3 should not be there. So, wherever 3 is there, 3 square minus this 2 square. Thank you. Plus as it is, x as it is. And again, this is also from 2 to 3 is there. Wherever y is there, if you put 3, 3 cube minus 2 cube. Divide by 3 as it is. Here divide by 2 as it is. Here divide by 3 as it is. So, these two will become some numbers. So, only x will remain, that is with respect to x, we should not forget dx and all that. So, So when I write remaining part, okay, can you integrate with respect to x now, remaining part? Today we have taken very simple definitions because first time you are getting used to this double integration. If at all I have taught you first time, it is my privilege and I'll be very happy. Now what is the meaning of this 9 minus 4 by 2? 9 minus 4 is 5 by 2. Then I am integrating x square dx. X square becomes x cube by 3 in the limit 1 to 2. What I did, this bracket simplification, 5 by 2, x square dx becomes x cube by 3 between 1 to 2, plus as it is, this simplification again, 27 minus 8, okay, 15 by 3, x dx becomes x square by 2 between 1 to 2. So a small thing to you, try to find the value between 1 to 2 and 1 to 2 again. Can anybody tell me the value? I am waiting for you. Or this is 27 minus 8. Change it. So I am waiting for you. So if you change it, 19 by 3. Now 5 by 2 as it is, 2 cube minus 1 cube. Just I wanted to see whether you have done the same thing. If so, so nice. 19 by 3, 2 square minus 1 square, some real number you will get. So next time we shall do some more examples. So 5 by 2 into 8 minus 1, 7 by 3 plus 19 by 3 into 4 minus 1, 3 by 2. Answer I am leaving to you. Like this, in the beginning, we take the help of definition of single integration, ordinary integration, extend it, and integration will be same provided when you are integrating with respect to x, suppose y will be kept constant or other way around. Similarly, triple integration we are learning, but limits we have taken always constants. Sometimes there are different types of limits. In the next class, we shall come up with better examples, different examples. Till that, take care. Bye.